Hello, Gavin Hoey here with another Photoshop tutorial. This week, I'm going to show you how to add snowflakes to your photographs using Photoshop. Well, I say we're using Photoshop, we're actually going to use my most favourite free plugin filter. So before you go into Photoshop, hop onto the internet and go to the Vandalee.com website. Now, Vandalee.com have got a bunch of filters, some of which are free, some of which you pay for. The best free one by a mile, in my opinion, is the Snowflakes filter. So download that, install it into Photoshop, and then fire up Photoshop once more. Okay, so this is the image we're going to create. Let's just go back to the beginning. Here we go. So this is how I brought it into the computer. It's a nice straightforward picture. These guys are a bunch of rappers, and they wanted a picture of them standing in front of a wintry scene. So I thought it'd be nice to add some snowflakes. But before we add the snowflakes in, we're going to do a little bit of work to prepare this picture. So let's go to the layers, and we're going to make an empty layer by clicking the new layer icon. So we now have a blank layer at the top of the stack. Let's swap colours so we have black as our foreground colour, and we'll just go to Edit, Fill, and fill it with the foreground colour. So we've now filled our picture with black. Right, we're ready to add in our snowflakes. Now, those are now under Filter, and right at the bottom of the list is the Vandalee Snowflakes filter. Now, this Snowflakes filter only does one thing, and it does it really well, and it makes snowflakes. So here's a few things you could do to improve it very slightly. First of all, I always drop the hardness down, because at the moment they're a little bit hard, and that's the default setting, so I take the hardness all the way down to zero. You can have more snow if you like. I actually prefer to have slightly less snow, so I'm going to have just around about 50 on the amount setting. You can also change the size of your snowflake, so you can have bigger ones, or you can have smaller ones. I think around about there looks pretty good to me. Now, if you want to, you can even change the colour of your snow. So perhaps you'd want to have red snow, like that. Perhaps you want to have sort of blue snow. Maybe you perhaps want to have yellow snow. But there's something about yellow snow that rings a bell. I've got a feeling it's bad. So we're not going to have any yellow snow. Let's stick to the snow-coloured snow. Yeah, that works really well. Okay, so there's the snow. We'll just click OK, and it'll apply that filter to our blank image. Now, we can't see the original picture. It's still there, of course. It's safe and underneath. But because we were using layers, and more specifically because we were using a black layer, we can change this blend mode to screen, and that black will become transparent, and you can now see the snow over the top of the picture. Now, you may be sitting there thinking, well, why didn't I just apply the snow directly to the picture? Why did I do all this layer business? Well, I could have done that, but the reason I've done it on a separate layer is because it gives me maximum control. So, for example, if I want to drop the opacity of this snow, I can do that, so I can have less obvious snow. Or, if I want to, I can paint on this snow layer. So let's get a paintbrush. We'll make sure that we have black as our foreground colour. And I'm going to drop the opacity of the brush to around about 70%. Now I can just paint over the faces, and that snow will sort of disappear. It's still there, but it's much softer now. So I can control where the snow goes. So if there's any areas where I don't want it to appear, I can just paint them out like so. Lovely. Okay, so there we are. There's how you do falling snow effects using Photoshop and the Vandalee Snowflakes free plugin filter.